Hi friends, this is Dr. S. Rekha, Associate Professor, Chemistry Department, RMD Engineering College, Chennai. Today our topic is Coronavirus Disease 2019, shortly called as COVID-19. This video lecture is recorded as an awareness creation among the people as well as a Part C question in Anna University Examination EVS paper. What is coronaviruses? Coronaviruses are a family of viruses that cause illness such as common cold, severe acute respiratory syndrome, SARS, SARS. In 2019, a new coronavirus was identified as the cause of a disease outbreak that originated in China. In China, it is said to be originated from bat to snake and from snake to man. There is no authentic information on that. Still, coronavirus has come from animal to man. The virus is now known as Severe Acute Respiratory Syndrome Coronavirus 2, shortly called as SARS-CoV-2. The disease it causes is called as Coronavirus Disease 2019, COVID-19. In March 2020, the World Health Organization declared the COVID-19 outbreak a pandemic. A pandemic means a disease which prevails all over the world. What are the symptoms of COVID-19? The symptoms may appear 2 to 14 days after exposure and can include fever, cough, shortness of breath or difficulty in breathing. These are the major symptoms of COVID-19, and other minor symptoms are tiredness, aches, running nose, sore throat, loss of smelling sense. What are the complications it can create? It can create the complications like pneumonia in both the lungs, organ failure in several organs. Causes. It spreads from person to person among those who in close contact, that is within 6 feet or 2 meters. You can see the marketplace. People are apart from each other, but we call them as they are in close contact because they don't maintain a distance of 6 feet or 2 meters. The virus spreads by respiratory droplet released when someone with the virus coughs or sneezes. Only for that purpose, people are asked to maintain a 6 feet or 2 meter distance so that the respiratory droplet does not reach them if a person is affected with the virus. It can also be spread if a person touches a surface in the virus on it and then touches his or her mouth, nose or eyes. So it is said that the virus first attacks your hand, and from your hand it enters your body through mouth, nose or eyes. So always wash your hands with soaps and then touch your mouth, nose or eyes so that virus does not enter your body. What are the risk factors about this COVID-19? How do you get this COVID-19 disease? If you have a recent travel from foreign countries or if you are residing in an area with ongoing community spread of COVID-19 as determined by CDC or WHO, close contact with someone who has COVID-19, such as when a family member or a healthcare worker takes care of an infected person. People who are older and who have existing chronic medical condition such as heart disease, lung disease or diabetes, or who have compromised immune system may be at risk of serious illness. So we can see that country like Italy, France, Spain, America, most of the people are dying because of COVID-19. It is because these old age people have compromised their immune system and so that they are not able to fight against this COVID-19. Prevention. There is no vaccine available to prevent infection with the new coronavirus. So we can take steps to reduce your risk of infection. WHO and CDC. CDC means Center for Disease Control, recommended following these precautions for avoiding COVID-19. So I am going to tell you the precautionary steps to avoid coronavirus. This has been prescribed by WHO. First point, avoid large event and mass gathering. For example, you can take Nizamuddin Marcus. Because of that gathering, India has increased 36% of COVID-19. Avoid close contact with anyone who is sick or has symptoms. So as said earlier, please keep a distance of 6 feet or 2 meters from person to person. This is also called as social distancing. Keep distance between yourself and if COVID-19 is spreading in your community. The other preventive measures are wash your hands often with soap and water for at least 20 seconds as directed, or use an alcohol-based hand sanitizer that contain at least 60% of alcohol. So washing the hand is very important as the virus first enter your body from hand, and from hand only it enters through into your body through nose, mouth and eyes. So on washing your hand regularly, you can avoid this disease. Cover your mouth and nose with your elbow or a tissue when you cough or sneeze. Throw away the used tissue so that it does not spread to other persons. Avoid touching your eyes, nose and mouth by wearing mask. Avoid sharing dishes, glasses, bedding and other household items if you are sick. Clean and disinfect high touch surface daily. Stay home from work, school and public areas. This is the most important thing. Please stay home so that you can 100% prevent this COVID-19 disease, and your nation can fight against the disease. Avoid taking public transport if you are sick. These are the preventive measures one should carry on to avoid this or to come out of this pandemic breakdown. But on the other hand, is it Malthus theory which is happening in the world? The famine and the other natural calamities cause widespread suffering and increase the death rate, which is nature's check against population. So according to Malthus theory, any disease or famine will cause to check the population on its own by nature. For all the problems in the environment like loss of ecosystem and biodiversity, extinct and endangered species, pollutions like air, water, soil, radiation, nuclear hazard, solid waste, domestic, industrial, medical and their management, depletion of resources, forest, water, food, soil, mineral, energy, etc., global warming, acid rain, ozone hole, issue related to developmental project, resettlement and rehabilitation issues, overpopulations. For all these, there was only one answer from the environmentalist, that is stop. Stop everything. The answer is stop. Stop everything. Stop pollution from factory, that is stop production. Stop textile and leather industry polluting rivers. Stop transport of goods. Stop travel. Stop car, train, flight. Stop burning of fossil fuel. Stop carbon emission. Everything has been stopped all over the world. Unbelievable. In the name of COVID-19 pandemic, never anybody thought such situation will arise. On the other hand, consoling part of this COVID-19 pandemic is that what is positive happening on the earth? A strong, bold decision each and every country leader has taken as lockdown. This will impact the economy surely, but to save life of people, they have taken a bold decision of lockdown. In the meantime, the earth will reduce its fever called global warming, carbon level will decline. This is the consoling part, main consoling part. Earth will reduce its fever called global warming, carbon level will decline. Delhi will have less polluted air. Delhi can breathe easily. So, Delhi can come out of its severe acute respiratory syndrome. Earth has taken its time to clean and recharge itself. The lockdown will have good effect on the environment. This will have positive impact on living in near future. This pandemic is causing a great loss of life worldwide. World is at fear. On the other hand, this lockdown will make life to sustain on Earth for many long years due to reduction in pollution. This is the consoling part of this pandemic. Now let us see the proactive measures taken by the Government of India in controlling the disease. Government of India, under the Epidemic Disease Act 1897, declared COVID-19 a notified disaster under the Disaster Management Act 2005. Government of India has been taking several proactive preventive and mitigation measures like progressive tightening of international travel, total lockdown of India at dry time for 21 days, thermal screening for detection of fever, setting up quarantine facilities, contact tracing of person infected by the virus. The passengers are further monitored in the community through the Integrated Disease Surveillance Program. If a person is infected, then the government immediately quarantines the family and the people who were in contact with the person, and the area is disinfected immediately. Various social distancing measures have been taken in the marketplaces. Necessary action for adequate hospitals' preparedness to meet with any possible emergency. All these measures are taken by the Union Health Ministry under the thought leadership role led by Prime Minister Honorable Modi ji. And this exercise is undertaken in cooperation with the state government. In a short time, India has enhanced from a single lab to 118 lab, which has a testing capacity of 15,000 tests. And also, it is in coordination with 47 private laboratories, which can collect 20,000 samples in the centers. The center has also instructed all the ministries and departments, particularly defense, railway, paramilitary forces and labor, and created dedicated COVID-19 blocks and hospitals. About 1.35 lakh isolation beds have already been identified, and railway wagons are also being converted as isolation bed for patients. An advisory for the use of antibody-based rapid testing has also been released by ICMR for easy scaling up of the test capacity. India has been lauded by WHO for taking proactive actions, which is impressive, to contain the spread of COVID-19. The world is appreciating the determination of our medical personnel and everyone who is involved in the disease management, and international team of frontline health workers who are performing their duties to the nation in the exemplary way and who have shown utmost commitment. Thus, the COVID-19 infection rate in India remains low relative to population size. I request all my students to stay home, stay safe. You are the back-end warriors for the pandemic COVID-19 outbreak disease. By staying home and staying safe, you can fight against this COVID-19 outbreak. And it is time for us to thank the front-end warriors like doctors, nurses, ward boys, sanitary workers, policemen, who are at high risk of this pandemic disease but working for us to keep us away from this COVID-19 pandemic and to fight against this COVID-19 for the nation's sake and to make us more safe. So all of you, please thank them for their good work at the time of need. Now, what is expected from you? Stay home, stay safe, and obey parents. My dear student, in this difficult time, work from home, that is, learn from home, daily watch the lecture videos posted in Google Classroom and make notes in all subjects. Big duties are waiting for you in future to compensate to the economic loss caused now due to the pandemic lockdown. Thank you, students.